Hey, what's going on everybody? Chad Christian coming at you with another exciting how-to video. Today I'm going to show you how to replace your mechanical hard drive in either the Alienware 15R3 or the 17R4. In this case, I am going to use the 15R3. As you can see, you've got 7 standard screws that you need to remove. Just note that on the very top screw in the middle above the ventilation system, that one does not come all the way out. So make sure you don't make the mistake of trying to release that all the way. Let me go ahead and fast forward this. We'll take all these screws out and then we'll move on to the next step. Now, once you've got all these removed, make sure that you remove the panel from the top because there is little tabs on the bottom that hold it in. Go ahead and remove that panel. As you can see, you got the mechanical hard drive down there. You got your sticks of RAM, hard drive slots, which is nice because this one will allow you to actually plug in 4 hard drives. So there's just those 3 screws, standard screws that you need to remove from the system there to get the little mounting bracket out. We do need to remove 4 more screws that are plugged into the 2.5-inch laptop drive that's connected to this mounting kit. So once we remove those screws, just go ahead and separate the hard drive from the docking tray. Once we've done that, we just need to remove the SATA cable, so go ahead and unplug that. So I'm going to go ahead and replace this with the Samsung 850 Pro drive. This is the 512. I'll leave a link down below for that. I'll also leave a link down below to my reviews of the 15R3 and the 17R4. So once you've got the drive plugged back into the mounting bracket, go ahead and screw in those 4 screws that you had removed previously. Once those are in place, go ahead and flip this over. Just be gentle. You don't pull on that cable, that little SATA cable. Replace your 3 screws that you used to remove the mounting bracket. Once you've done that, make sure you put in the little slots on the bottom there first of the back panel. And once you've done there, little tip for you that I like to do, I like to use an alternate screwing in pattern. So what I do is, instead of screwing in one side, either top, bottom, left, or right, you can see that I kind of move around different locations on the system from corners to corners. And the reason I do that is because then it mounts the plate in, basically all at the same time instead of having one side bow up or down. Once that's done, just make sure that everything is connected well and you should be good to go. Turn on your system and you will see the new drive. So, hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, make sure you leave a thumbs up. I appreciate it, and I'll see you guys on the next video.